Saints of God,
Bazalwan.
We are in the month of July.
July.
It's a month of restoration.
The year
2024, it's a year of supernatural restoration. When we talk about restoration, we are talking about me and you experiencing the manifestation,
the
happening of all the good things that God purposed for my life. Lift up your hand and say, oh Lord my God, may I succeed, may I do well, may I be glorified, may my life be made attractive now that I'm a Christian. Deliver me from living a life of failure, life of struggling, life of suffering, life of poverty, life of sickness, life of having problems with other people, life of failure. Say, deliver me in the name of Jesus now that I belong to you. Say, in this month of July, the month of restoration, the month of perfection, perfect everything that concerns me. Correct everything that has gone wrong in my life. Pray like you pray. Correct everything that has gone wrong in my life. Please pray. When I say pray, respect. I'm not an entertainer here. Yes, the Holy Spirit tells me what to tell you. Why are you quiet? Pray. Say, Holy Spirit, fix everything that has gone wrong in my life. Correct my life now in the name of Jesus. Pray like you're praying. Rise to your feet. Listen to me. Many people are not living the original life that God purposed for them through sin, through their stubbornness, through their blunders. The devil has messed up everything in their lives. Say, oh Lord my God, in this month of restoration, fix everything that has gone wrong in my life. Perfect me. Pray like you're praying. Makata zita mayanta masaka. Pray. I don't waste time. I want people to pray. You are not here to look at other people. You are not here to look at how I'm dressed. You are here to connect with destiny. You are here to connect with every plan of God for your life. Are you understanding me? You are not here to look at the person that is sitting next to you. You are here to fight for your destiny. Every week, your life must make a progress. Every week, your life must move forward. Every week, there must be improvement. Every week, there must things that were not there that must come into your life. Are you understanding me? Pray like you're praying. In Jesus' name we pray. Take your seats. Take your seats. Please listen to me. God prospers you in two ways. He prospers you by giving you the Holy Spirit of prosperity, who then guides you day after day and whispers ideas to you and tells you things to do. Holy Spirit is the spirit of improvement. Are you learning something? That's why after you are born again, learn to talk to him. Learn to connect with him. I call Holy Spirit the school of prosperity. Are you learning something? That's how God prospers you. He puts the Holy Spirit who becomes the
power of heaven that lives on the inside of you. No matter who you are, educated or uneducated, Holy Spirit is for improving every human being.
Hallelujah.
Are you learning something? Lift up your and say, Father, may the Holy Spirit influence my life, direct my life, rule in my life. May Holy Spirit improve me. He is the spirit of prosperity and total wellness. Holy Spirit, you are the power of prosperity. You are the power of all round wellness. Holy Spirit, you have come to make me a better person, an improved person, a transformed person, a good person. Say, Holy Spirit, you have come to change me, to become the person God designed me to be in my lifetime. Are you learning something? Are you sure you are learning something? Are you sure? The second system by which God improves you is to connect you to the grace of prosperity. Many people are members of this church, but they are not connected to what God has placed in me. There is something God has placed in me. If you come here, listen to my testimonies. And I pray for you. You go. Your life may remain the same. You need to live a life of putting a demand on what God places on His anointed servant. Paul once spoke a mystery. Two mysteries you must never forget. You see, if you are a member of this church, and you just see me as a preacher, you are mistaken. I was an ordinary person. I was going discourse. I was drinking alcohol. I was chasing after girls. I was a naughty boy. But one day, God chose me. All of you are Christian. I'm a Christian and something. I am a Christian like you. And I'm supposed to live as a Christian. But I've got another advantage. Out of the Christians of Eswatini, God said this one must not only be a Christian, he must also be my servant. The Bible says many are called, few are chosen. I don't know how God decided it to choose such a naughty boy like me. He said, I want justice. So the day heaven decided to choose me, I became different from you. Because for me to function, for me to impact God's people, He had to put in me what you don't have. When you come to church, come to receive the word. Number one, come to strengthen your relationship with God. Number two, those things will take you to heaven. Number three, come to connect yourself, to tap, to unlock that thing that God has placed upon His servant. Paul spoke something, I want you to take note of it. He says in Philippians 4:19, he says, my God shall supply all your needs. Why are you in need? When God is able to supply,
all your needs. He says, my God. Now, this is English by the translators. What Paul was saying, he said, because you Philippians are giving me your money to go around preaching the gospel, the grace God has placed in me will begin to do wonders for you. The second thing that Paul says to the same church of Philippi, this one is amazing. The New King James, Philippians chapter 1, verse number 6, he begins by saying, I'm persuaded, I'm confident of this thing, that the God who began a good work in you will finish it, will keep on pushing you forward. God does not start something in someone and then leave it. Once he starts with you, he goes along with you to ensure you never fail. He said, he who began this good work, he will complete it until the day of Jesus. Number seven, verse seven. Look at that one. That one is a mind blower. He says, just it is right for me to think this of you all, because I have you in my heart. Every week, connect yourself to God through prayer. When you kneel down, say, God, pour more of you in me. That's the right way of praying. Not this prayer request praying. When you just kneel down in the morning, say, Father God, pour more of you in me. Fill me with your presence. The presence of God is the terminator of suffering. Stop the other praying. Say, Father, fill me with your presence. Let your Holy Spirit saturate and occupy all of me. And even influence my actions, my talking, my conduct. Pray like that. Say, Father God, lift up your hands. You see, when you lift up your hands like this, it's a sign of surrender. Lift your hands like this. What? It's a sign of receiving something from God. When you kneel down like I do, it's a sign of humbling yourself before Him so that He lifts you up. Lift up your hands. It's a sign of telling God, without you I'm nothing. When you lift up your hands, that's what you are saying. Lift them high. Say, Father God, fill me right now with your holy presence. Without your presence in my life, I am dead alive. I'm a walking corpse. Without your presence, I am dead. Without your presence, I am doomed. Say, Father God, clean me with the blood from all sin, and then fill me with your presence. Saturate me. Please, I'm helping you. Why are you quiet? Saturate me with your presence. Flood me now with your presence, because your presence makes me whole. Your presence completes me. Pray, oh Shalina Masuka. Your presence completes me, Lord. Your presence completes me. Your presence heals me. Your presence perfects me. Pray like you are praying. I'm watching some people. Why are you quiet? Lord, cry out and say, Holy Spirit, occupy my whole person. Holy Spirit, influence me. Holy Spirit, keep on improving my conduct, my behavior, my attitude. Holy Spirit, keep on improving my behavior, my attitude.
attitude, my conduct, change me, perfect me, restore me back to the glorious life. Let the glory of the Lord be made manifest in my life. Sani Baba Jehovah, ngigwalise ngebukhona bakho, ebukhoneni bakho. Kwendeka timanga ngisonzethe ebukhoneni bakho. Fill me with your presence, saturate me. Sina lina masuka lepro hashana masaka lepra kapazete maya limro hashina masaka eshala masaka maya. Say, whenever I kneel down, I will cry for your presence. I will no longer cry for things, because it is your presence that brings the things I need. Sanba beksugela manje nanguka ngithandaza, ngawukhalela bukhona bakho, ngoba bukhona bakho lobuletha letinto, bukhona bakho lakimi lobuvula nemsebenzi, bukhona bakho lakimi lobukosha botokoloshi, bukhona bakho lakimi lobukosha emakhesisi, because ebukhoneni bakho ikhesi ngeke isebenze. Jehovah, fill me with your presence. Pray like I pray. Zitalina masukabaya. Hey! Listen to me.
Lalelani.
So, two things you do all the time.
Lokubili lokumele ukwenze njalo njalo.
Ukhalela ukugcwaliswa ngebukho.
You cry to be filled by his presence.
Ukhalela ukuthi influence ya Holy Spirit.
Cry that the Holy Spirit influence.
Grow
and grow.
Ube netinto lozo ukhulume wedwa.
So that there are things that you
need to speak on your own.
And say, Holy Spirit has helped me to stop doing this.
Ngeke bazalwane.
It cannot be.
You can't walk in God's favor.
Ngehambe ngaphansi kwemswa kaNkulunkulu.
Unenhliziyo lembi.
With an evil heart. Ngeke.
Nabe nje wena usebenza.
If your work is
ukwatela neqasukela abantu.
To always frown upon people.
Uziyolala unjalo.
Until you go to sleep like that.
Favor walks away.
Umusa ngeke uzokube nawe uyahamba.
Hayi kuthi kusho mina.
It's not me who saying this.
Uyadincenga.
You have to plead with yourself.
Bantu batasilimata kuze kube ya Jesus.
People will be hating us until Jesus comes.
Awukholwa lo Matthew 5:7.
Never forget Matthew 5:7.
Every day.
Onke malanga.
What I need the most and what you need the most.
Lekudzinga kona lokudzinga kakhulu.
Now it's mercy.
Umusa.
I'm telling you for free. And the Christians don't have this revelation. Men of God, what we need is not powerful prayer.
Lesi kudinga kusimithandazo le manje.
It is mercy.
Kudinga how?
There is a way of getting it to your life. Wake up every day.
Uvuka onke malanga.
Greet your enemies.
Uvusele lentisa takho.
Send a WhatsApp message.
Uthumele umlayeto wa WhatsApp.
Uthi this morning.
Namhle kuseni.
I just want God to bless you.
Mufuna nje ngurugula
kusasa. Abone lo mlene ngevani ngena le message.
The person whom you are not telling along will see this coming.
You just opened.
Na wena njalo uvule
window of favor.
Lizifastela lemusa.
Over your life.
Etikwempilo yakho.
You don't defeat bantu abakhluphako by fighting them.
You don't defeat your enemies ngesulwe nabo.
You defeat those who treat you bad.
Kodwa uyabuhlekuhlulekise nabakulisango. Ngekuthi wena ubaphathela.
The Bible says ubeka lahle.
The Bible uthi aphuthe nge hot coal.
You force them to change.
Ubaphathele baguquke.
If you return bad.
Now buyisela bubu buyisela bubu.
When you do kubi ngoba nawe bakwendeka.
When you doing bad because they've done you bad.
Both of you go down.
No babili nishona phansi.
This verse I don't forget. Why? I need mercy.
Ngiyasidinga sawu.
Why?
Len.
No human being is perfect. Mercy forces God to overlook my blunders. Forget about walking in favor if you don't intentionally treat people good. If you live life just for you, everything you do for you, you worry about you, favor will reject you. Lift up your hands and pray. The Holy Spirit once spoke to me and said, Justice. The devil has got a weapon that he uses to kill favor in people's lives. He caused them to pay attention to the bad things people do to them. The moment they get angry, the moment they become bitter, favor goes. You can lose everything in this life. Never lose God's presence. Never lose His mercy. Talk to God. In the year 2022, when I turned 60, I decided to start a fund, gather money that I keep in a particular account under a foundation to pay school fees for students whose parents are dead. For students whose parents cannot are dysfunctional. So we took the students. We started paying for them, Edward. The year 2022. By November 2022, I'm sitting in a restaurant with a friend of mine in America. He says to me, Apostle, America is better than Swaziland. What can I do to help you do some kind of business in Swaziland? Immediately, I thought of property because I have got plots. Myself and my wife have got plots we bought. So I said, if you can help me develop one of my plots, it says to me, go back to Swaziland, draw the plan of what you want to build. Can you imagine? He says, send me the budget. So I came back, get my architect, we went to the plot, we throw. I wanted to build apartments we can rent out. So I sent him. I thought the man was joking. After about 3 weeks, he saw the budget. He sent me $1.8 million. He said, start building. What am I trying to tell you? It's impossible to inconvenience yourself and help other people at your level and remain the same. It's impossible. Don't hear me wrong. I'm not boasting. When you see an anointed man of God, there's something in him that he carries that can sweep away all your suffering. But there's something you need to do. Even if you are a woman who's selling cabbages and tomatoes in the market, there's a way of tapping into what God has placed in my life. The people in the days of Elisha, They never tapped into the anointing.
Elisha
took the anointing to the grave. They came to bury a man who died. They placed him on the bones of Elisha. The dead man rose. My bones are not like your bones. Are you hearing me? They placed the men on the dead bones. The men rose. Don't let me take what I carry to other nations. From this July to December, I want things to change in your life. Ask me, Apostle, what must I do? This is what you must do. Partake to the grace. This is what I do. Look at this verse. In Philippians 1:7, I want to show brothers, highlight the last part. If you don't see what I'm going to show you today, I'm no longer responsible for your suffering. Give it to us in the King James, the original rendition, exactly how Paul said it. Paul says, even in this, it is proper for me to think this of you all, because I have you in my heart. Inasmuch as in my bones, in the defense and the confirmation of the gospel, he says, I go everywhere preaching the gospel, I face challenges, but I keep on preaching. And then look at the last part. He says, ye all are partakers. By releasing your money so that I use it to carry God's work, when you release it direct to me, that's how you make yourself a partaker. Listen. Combine your tithing together with giving me your money direct to meet the expenses of running this work. Help the anointing to run this. The anointing will help you to break. Did you hear what I've said? So this is how you partake, right? You go to the man of God like people go to witch doctors with brown envelopes, and they place the envelope at the feet of the witch doctor. You come to the man of God after selling your tomatoes and your cabbages in the week. You put something aside. You drop your normal offering here, and there's an envelope that you use to tap into the grave. When I say to you direct, God bless you, and I receive your offering, when I take it, you also take it. Listen to how Paul puts it. Look at verse number 15, Philippians chapter 4 this time. Look at it. He says, you Philippians, and they are the only ones, chapter 4, look at verse 15. Let's put it in the NIV. Read like you're alive. 1, 2, 3, 4, read. Not one change shared with me in the matter of giving and receiving. Nine bazalwane base Philip.
You Philippians,
inotwa lenibambele mfihlo.
You are the only one who has kept his secret.
Each time you release your substance,
uibeke
tandleni tampawu,
and put it in the head of
coal.
There is something that comes out from
you. Receive
nguwe. You receive it.
Uthi when the business the
come
in.
When you go to business, it just booms.
Ubambisa lolugobo.
You are aiding the anointing. Then the anointing will help you.
Hallelujah.
That's how it works. What is unfair with this thing called grace? You don't need to do anything to get it.
It's because I already lute ukuthola.
Njengam it's upon my life, not because I'm a good man.
Like myself, kulaki maya ngoba ngumlolongile.
Mercy chose me.
God says, I
show mercy on whom I want
to.
I
was just lucky. And I don't want to be proud about that because I was just chosen. I have that thing. It's in me.
No, was Imbela.
Yes.
How can I have people, 51,000 people are following me? Balanzela in
Laban. 51, but what are they following if I'm not
there?
How Facebook many are following you on Facebook?
No, but with all due respect, this
thing is alive.
You know, Pastor Selewa mentioned something powerful. He says, those that God foreknew, knew before time, he called. That is us before by salvation. Those he called. Is Romans 8, I think it's verse 28 there. He says, those he predestined, he called. After calling them, he justified them. Acquitted them from their sins. After justifying them, he glorified them. He adopted them into sonship. So we became sons and daughters of God. After that, he glorified us. What is to be glorified? Is there people who knew you before you met Jesus? All of a sudden your life shines. All of a sudden you are just doing well in life. To be glorified is to be supernaturally elevated in life. Lift up your hands. Look at it. From verse 29, look at it there. My God, for those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of this son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. Look at verse number 31. Jesus. Verse 30. My God, read verse 30 together. I want it to enter your spirit. And those he predestined, he also called. Say, I'm called. Those he called, he justified. To justify is to acquit from sin. Say, I'm acquitted. Those he justified, he also glorified. Lift up and say, Father, I want a glorified life. I want a life that is attractive. A life that makes Jesus attractive. Glorify me, my Lord. Pray like you pray. Glorify me, Holy Adonai. Glorify me, my Lord. Sila masukabayana. Make me to prosper, Lord, so that by me your name may be glorified. Say thank you, Jesus. Are you blessed so far? So never come to the church or anywhere. Saints of God, when I attend meetings and conferences in Swaziland or South
Africa
or wherever I go, I've been doing this for years because many men of God carry different graces. I will always ask for a permission to the organizers of that conference.
Say,
allow me to give a special offering to the men of God. Because I'm from a family of sufferers. Family of people who never achieved anything notable. So by tapping into the graces of different servants of God, I give speed to my life. You can be holy, but be a holy sufferer. Are you hearing me? Holiness takes you to heaven. Favor gives you the things of this life easy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lift up your hands, Father. I've opened their eyes.
Amen.
Holy Spirit, teach them. Some of them have suffered for too long. Prayer has not helped them. Let them release, my Father, their substance, their sweat, and support direct with their direct money, apart from tithes, because tithes is God's money. Their money is what they give out of the 90%. To say, with this one I connect to the grace. Help them, my Father, to do well. In Jesus' name. Amen.